Hi, I'm Claire Hoffman, and I wrote The Last Days of Michael Jackson for the cover of Rolling Stone. Like everybody else, I grew up with Michael Jackson. And that was kind of a cool thing about reporting the story was that you meet all these different people who are like, 10, 20 years apart, but everybody's like, well, I grew up with him. I find people who are like objects of fame, like fame objects, like really interesting, and Michael Jackson is the quintessential one, and he seemed so tortured by it that I've like definitely enjoyed reading about him over the years and felt really sorry for him or felt like very confused about what he was doing or concerned. The day after he died, I flew back from Utah and then started going around immediately to all the rehearsal spaces that he had been working in, which there were three of them. And, talking to people who had, just been around, like security guards and session musicians and like the owner of center staging, and just trying to get a sense of what they thought, because I thought they seem like the people who would have the least amount of spin, like they're just like people who were there and saw him working. And right away from the beginning, it seemed like what everybody was saying, like even people who had nothing to gain, everybody was saying like he was really, really into this, like he was so pumped about doing this tour, and it was everybody who worked with him felt it and felt like this momentum and this thing, like this is gonna be this great thing. Like he wanted it to be the greatest show on earth. I think the most surprising thing that I felt was that he did have this part of his life that was very normal, I mean, for all the like masks and like uniforms and like the weird stuff, like he seemed really into being a parent. This is sort of like a second life for him. I mean, Lou Ferrigno called him like Mr. Mom, and you kind of do get this feeling like he like loved it more than almost anything, being a parent. I do think it'll be like Elvis, and this, I'm sure they're gonna do something with Neverland. I can't imagine they're not going to capitalize on that. Basically, what I did was just sort of listen to what everybody around him was saying, and everybody around him was saying the same thing, which is just like he came very close to putting his life back together. I mean, he had his old manager, who's just like this great guy, and he'd gotten together with AEG, which is, an incredibly well-organized promotion company. His kids were old enough that like maybe at some point they could start having some kind of normal life. It seemed like things could have were kind of on in the direction of being less crazy for him, and right at that moment is when he died. And sad.